A picture is worth a thousand words, but it has to be a really good picture. Molecular visualization is an essential part of modern science communication, and using the right methods will help you create better papers, posters, and presentations. In this tutorial, we're going to get a basic introduction to ChimeraX, use it to load a protein structure from the protein databank, and explore different ways to style it, such as cartoons, sticks, spheres, and surfaces. We will also learn how to style specific parts of the protein. ChimeraX is free and open source, runs on Windows, Linux, and Mac, and is very easy to get started with. You can download it from the link in the description. Once ChimeraX is installed, we can get to work. This is the ChimeraX interface. We can build new structures from scratch, which we will not do this time, and we can load existing structures from files on our computer or from online databases. We're going to load the PDB structure using the open command. In the command prompt, we type open and the PDB identifier, in this case 3NHN. And we can see that the protein was loaded with the default style of cartoon. Chimera usually has good defaults for newly loaded structures. Since we want to demonstrate different stylings, we're going to load the same structure 5 more times by pressing Enter 5 more times for the same open command. We can see in the Models panel that the model has been loaded 6 times. But we can see that all the structures overlap each other. We need to position them differently. First, let's zoom out. We can do that using the mouse wheel. Now, to make our lives a bit easier, we'll go to the right mouse section and choose Drag Model. Now we can use the right mouse button to drag the models to different places on the canvas. We'll arrange the 6 models so they don't overlap. And now let's get to styling them. First, we'll select the first model. We can do that using this checkbox near the model name in the Models panel. And to get started, we'll just change its color scheme to rainbow. The rainbow coloring is good to understand how the structures of the protein correspond to the primary sequence of the protein. Let's unselect it and select the second model. Now let's hide the cartoon and show the atoms. And unselect it. You can see that this is not the most convenient way to display a large protein. We usually use the atomic representation for smaller molecules, but it's there if you need it. Now let's select the third model. And again, we will hide the cartoon, show the atoms, and this time style it as spheres. The sphere representation gets us an idea of how much space different parts of the protein take. For example, it shows us cavities where ligands can bind, or surfaces that come in contact between monomers. For the next examples, ChimeraX provides very easy shortcuts. Let's style this model as hydrophobic surface. This type of representation is suitable, for example, for transmembrane proteins. It would show us that the hydrophobic parts come in contact with the membrane and the hydrophilic parts come in contact with the cytosolic or extracellular parts. Let's move on to the next model. And very similarly, style it with electrostatic surface. In the electrostatic surface representation, we can see red parts representing negative charges and the blue parts representing positive charges. The neutral parts are colored white. It's suitable to show us parts of the protein that are likely to participate in electrostatic interactions with ligands or other proteins or solvent. For the last example, we'll do something a bit more interesting. We will add a surface but we don't want it to cover the cartoon entirely. We want to make it semi-transparent. So we'll go to Action, Surface, and set its transparency to something like 70%. And now we can see in one representation both the cartoon and the surface of the protein. Let's take it a bit further by coloring different parts of the protein. This protein contains two domains, SH3 and SH2. We can see which residues each domain span in the protein PDB page. To select only part of the residues, we'll go to the command line and use the cell, short for select, command. Choose the model, which is number 6, and from it, after semicolon, we will type the residue range. The SH3 domain spans the residues 87 to 134. So this way we select only these residues. And now we can color them without coloring the rest of the protein. Again, we will do this for the SH2 domain, which spans residues 148 to 230, and color it with a different color, like so. Now, when you present your structures in a presentation or in a website, a black background may be suitable. But when you want to produce publication figures, you would usually use a white background. This can be done very easily using the presets. You have two presets for publications. Any of them would get you white background, and you can very easily use it to export figures that would go on your publications. When you finish your work, you would probably want to save it. You can either save it as a Chimera session. This way, all your styling and anything you did is saved as part of the session. You can then reload it and continue your work as it is with the same structures as you see now. Alternatively, you may want to produce a more standard format, such as PDB. Or you may want to export an image of your structure. You can even export videos, but we'll cover this another time. At this point, I would like to quote the statistician George Box: "All models are wrong, but some are useful." Different molecular visualization styles may better fit different cases, and it's up to you to choose the styles that make sense. It's a common practice to use the same structure with different styles, and even use different styles in the same molecule. We will expand on different cases in the following tutorials. If you have any questions or requests, you're welcome to write in the comments. Thank you for watching. Go make beautiful molecular visualizations, and I'll see you in the next video.